Hello there, you malt majesties, and thank you, Matt, for your meticulously Matt malt mention. Yes, it's been mentioned, Matt, and thank you. And welcome, one and all, to another of Ralfy's potty whisky reviews. Yes, a glass pot, in fact, fairly unusual, slightly classy, if I say so myself, and this is the feature in Whisky Review 236. Yes, blend your own. It's a new phenomenon. It's part of the evolution of the Scotch whisky industry. So all you distillers around the world, take note, because this is where it's at the moment. Yes, this is where it's happening. There's two companies in Scotland who are giving you the opportunity to blend your own whisky online through the website and then buy the bottle from them that you've blended. Quite a good idea, quite a novel idea, and I think a great way of organising a very individual present for someone. Now, the two companies at the moment are doing this. There's Master of Malt, which is a big online retailer, who also do these little sample bottles of whisky, which you can buy and try before you commit yourself to a full-size bottle, which may disappoint you. There's many a bottle of whisky on a whisky shop shelf or an online website where you're looking at it and you're saying, you know, I'd buy that, but I just don't know what it tastes like. Now, the retailers are very much aware of this, and it's certainly the case that a small specialist bottle shop will usually have something for you to sample if you are showing an interest and if you're being genuine. If you're just taking the piss and looking for free drink in a high street shop or whatever, forget it. They'll soon suss you out and send you on your way. Moving on. Online retailers who are blending your own bottle for you. Master of Malt are doing it, but the other company that are doing it, whiskyblender.com. Now, because I've kind of known the guys behind this, who I've met many times in my malt travels, and I know that they do have access to good quality whisky, which is the reason that I decided to roll the dice and become one of their first customers and buy a bottle. And you go to the website, and basically they give you an option of a number of whiskies. They don't tell you the name of the distillery. What they do is they give you information about the character and the nature of the whisky itself to help you decide what proportion of that whisky you want to put into your blend. And importantly, they give you the price as well, so as you can keep an eye on your pennies as you're busy blending up your bottle. Then they send it off to you through the post. This is what this bottle arrived in, as you can see, a nice strong bottle, good, sturdy, and very attractive, with those broad shoulders and kind of a waistline somewhat rather like my own, actually. And they send it in a good strong box with plenty of bubble wrap. Wonderful. Let's pour a glass. As you can see, I've been busy preparing for this review over the last few days. Funnily enough, when I first opened this bottle, I'll bring hold the bottle forward to let you see it. Here it is, Ralfy's Blend by Ralfy on the 27th of... Oh. I've just knocked over my microphone. Damn and drat. That's it. Stay. You don't see it because I wouldn't want it intruding in the, you know, in the aesthetics of the Manx bothy. Right, where was I? Yeah, when I opened this bottle and the first glass I poured, I thought, I'm not sure about this. There's a really good arrival, but there's not a lot of complexity. But in fact, what I was experiencing was the phenomenon that can happen when you put various whiskies together, and then open the bottle in a very short space of time, short while later. The whiskies haven't had time to marry together and to really kind of get to kind of know each other and settle down. But now that I've had three or four glasses, five or six or seven glasses, the complexity is starting to come through. And first thing I noticed is there's plenty of fresh cask, particularly bourbon cask influence here. Now, I don't know if all the whiskies are single malts, but that doesn't bother me, because if there's grain whiskey is one of the options here, one of the cheaper whiskey options. Grain whiskies properly matured in good cask can be excellent. So here's my whiskey blender list. I'll actually post on the YouTube channel video what the components of this whiskey are. But I do recommend, if you decide to take this option, don't blend what other people are blending. Blend your own. Follow your instincts. Carefully review what whiskies are available and then take it from there in your own proportions. It's going to create something unique that isn't unique to other people, only to yourself. And that's what makes this that little bit special. Also, this cost me £53.91. Now, this is, of course, including postage in the British Isles. So I think that inclusive of postage, that's actually quite a decent price, so long as the quality of whisky is good. So let's bash on with the tasting notes. It's a very rich, honey, fudgy arrival. Interestingly, this whisky that I've blended here is better without any water added. Now, I'm never through adding water to my whisky. It's just a thing that I do to open it up and generate the complexity that lies therein. But in this case, it's more complex and it has more of a richness without water being added. So there we have it. It's that old saying, every bottle of whiskey needs to follow the rule book, but the great whiskies are the ones that know how to break the rules. Nose, fudgy, wood spice, mild grain, citrus, and lots of honey. Fresh cask, very much to the fore here. Lime rind and coriander develop, along with vanilla and some wood floral. And into the finish, vanilla, oak, and a touch of raisin. Yeah. Again, over time, hints of nutmeg and chocolate are appearing on the nose. Taste-wise, good quality. Big, soft, sweet, enormously sweet, wood-infused honey arrival. And it stays that way for about 5 or 10 minutes in the glass. And then some complexity is coming through. Spices and vanilla are developing over time. The sweetness becomes more influenced by wood sour, so we've got more of a balance kicking in here. Some mint into the finish. Bitter cola develops. Now, bitter cola is not something I come across in a whiskey very often, but it's certainly here, with some coal smoke and bitter camphor. And again in the finish, vanilla, oak, and mint. So there we have it. A pretty decent whiskey, decent enough to give it 88 out of 100. Now, I do not know if all the whiskies in this are single malt whiskies. There could be grain whiskies involved here, which is fine. As I've mentioned, if the quality's there, it really doesn't matter where the whiskey has, if it, whether it's come from some small pot still or a column still. That doesn't bother me. It's about the intrinsic quality, and the quality here is just fine. I'm thoroughly enjoying this, and it's absolutely unique. Now, this uniqueness is something that you create for yourself. Again, have a look and see what you think. It's something that I'm happy to mention, because this is something that isn't really super expensive. It's not something that's been presented as ultra deluxe, premium, exclusive, you know, and elitist. This is something which is unique and very much available for the cost of a 14 or 15 year old whiskey. And I think that's, well, that certainly rings my malt bell. So, whiskey blender, nor or I wonder, I hope you can see that okay. Let's get the lighting level up a little bit. So I'm going to not say I, because I, of course, means yes. I am of legal drinking age in my country. Yes, I am, honestly. And it takes you into the site, and there you have it, the bottle. And it basically suggests you've got a choice of 7 different whiskies with different characteristics, all different. And basically, as you go through selecting the quantities you want, this bottle here, the empty bottle, starts to fill up. And at the end, you've got a little, two little boxes. One box to put the name of your blend, and the other box to put the name of the blender. There you are. And then someone's end of year or new year present is more or less sorted, is it not? So there we have it. Hope you find this interesting. I like to, you know, keep abreast of what's happening in the online, rather than just sort of waiting for the latest innocuous and completely random and usually fictitious rumour to roll out the rumour mill from Whiskey Central. Don't believe half of what you hear, folks. It really, at the end of the day, it's about the whiskey itself. What really matters to you and what really matters to me is the intrinsic quality, so that when you open the bottle, whether it be a single malt, whether it be a blended whiskey, whether it be anything at all, and you take a glass, you're not disappointed in relation to what you've paid for it. That's what really matters. So, here we are, another malt mission accomplished here at Ralfy.com with this whiskey review. Unique stuff. I think we're going to see more of it. In fact, I don't think it'll be too long before we see blend your own bourbon. There you go. There's an idea. Blend your own brandy. Another idea. Blend your own rum. Excellent stuff. I'm Ralfy, and I'm afraid I come ready blended, folks. I can't just be stuffed in a bottle, although a bottle can be stuffed into me. Slowly. I pressed the wrong button to my remote. This is my remote control, folks. And it's got a little red button you press, and it puts off automatically, so I don't have to spend time editing these vlogs. And do you know what? I've pressed the wrong button. I should have pressed the big red button, and I pressed the little red button. What a bumpkin.